The TARDIS spins through the time-space vortex. Inside, the Doctor stands at the console, watched by his companions, Polly, Ben, and Jamie.
There we are, in perfect flight.
Yes, and look what happened last time.
Oh, that, what a lot of fuss. Just a bumpy landing, that's all. It won't happen again. I know.
What are you up to now?
Let's have a look at the time scanner.
The what?
The time scanner. Instead of the normal picture showing where we are, it gives you a glimpse of the future.
The second sight.
Very dangerous.
Oh, nonsense. I haven't used it very much. It's not very reliable, as you can see.
Doctor? Look!
On the scanner, an enormous claw stretches out towards them. Doctor Who, The Macra Terror, by Ian Stuart Black. Episode 1. A bearded face stares out into the darkness, the eyes narrowed, trying to make out something in the gloom. Suddenly, the eyes open wide in fear. Behind the protective walls of a technologically advanced community, a troupe of majorettes is performing to a flock of people. The crowd is dressed in utilitarian tunics, and everyone is dancing and smiling with glassy-eyed happiness. The pilot of the colony and Barney, the refreshing department supervisor, are looking on with obvious satisfaction.
Splendid, splendid. You've got a very good band there, Barney.
Thank you, pilot.
Mind you, I don't say you'll come first to the festival, but never say die. What? Nothing succeeds like success. If at first you don't succeed...
Try again.
That's
stop
right.
Stop it, don't let it get out!
What's the matter?
Oh. Me, Doc. Let me go.
Me, Doc. Now, this is very foolish of you, me, Doc. It's for your own good.
Out of my way!
It's far too dangerous to be allowed to escape.
Ola is in pursuit.
Get after him!
You should have stopped him.
What happened, Ola?
He refused treatment in front of my guard, so I dismissed him and he made a dash for it.
I'll get after him. He must not get away.
Medoc runs as hard as he can out of the colony, over scrubby grassland and down towards a rocky valley. He drops to a crouch as the corpulent silhouette of Ola appears on the rise behind him, flanked by helmeted guards. Medoc looks frantically from side to side like a hunted animal, and then breaks cover, taking off at a staggering run. Ola spots him and leads his guards in the chase. The fugitive tumbles down a steep slope of scree to the bottom of the valley. He picks himself up and runs on, splashing through the shallow pools of water, trying to lose his pursuers among the rocks. But they are closing in. Medoc doubles back and goes to ground in a narrow gully. Ola and the guards run straight past his hiding place. The sound makes Medoc look up, and he watches in astonishment as a large blue box materializes on the shelf of rock above him. He ducks down out of sight and works his way around the outcrop, trying to find a way up behind the incongruous artifact. The door of the police box opens, and Jamie cautiously steps out, looking around as though expecting an attack. He stoops to pick up a fallen branch. Behind him, the Doctor, Ben and Polly emerge from the TARDIS, glancing about themselves nervously. Ben gives the Doctor a mischievous grin and creeps up behind Polly.
Wait!
Oh! Oh, Ben, for goodness sake.
Well, what's the big stick for, Jamie? Nothing's happened yet.
Oh, have you no sense? Have you forgotten what we saw in that time scanner?
Don't. It was horrible.
Aye, well, I'm not being left without nothing to defend ourselves with.
I'm afraid you're wasting your time, Jamie.
Why?
Unless I'm very much mistaken, these creatures are so big, they're going to see us long before we see them.
Look out, Jamie!
Hang on, wait, I'll get him!
Medoc is wrestling with Jamie for the stick, but Ben flies in with a rugby tackle.
Oh, no, Ben, all right.
Go away, can't you?
Come on, Ben. Roll him over on his back. That's it, son.
Get him, that's the
trouble.
Well done!
Ben gets Medoc pinned to the ground, just as Ola and his guards arrive.
We don't know who you are, strangers, but we are grateful.
Medoc is one of our last patients in the colony. We've done our best for him, but he gets worse day by day.
The guards haul Medoc to his feet and tie his hands behind his back.
I wasn't informed you were travelling across our territory.
Ola instructs the guards.
Hurry back to the colony and tell the pilot what's happened.
Pilot?
Yes, the pilot of our colony. No doubt he will want to thank you in person. Tie him up tighter. Come on, tighter. I don't want any more trouble with him. Come on, I'll show you myself.
Jamie nudges the doctor.
Any good asking where we are?
Well, according to my calculations, we're certainly in the future and on a planet very like the Earth.
How do you know?
I don't know. I'm guessing.
My name is Ola. I'm the chief of police.
That sounds very important.
Oh, it's a very responsible job. I take my instructions from our control center. Oh, it all works very well, as you will see. Please follow me.
Oh, thank you.
As Ola struts off, the doctor has a word with the guards about Medoc's bonds.
Not too tight. It's bad for the blood pressure.
And they all follow Ola back towards the colony.
Strangers that have helped us.
Very well, Ola. I will look after our guests. You will no doubt wish to take care of poor Medoc. You may leave. Well, our thanks to you and welcome. You are indeed a brave man to tackle someone as disturbed as Medoc.
It was nothing. Anyone would have done the same.
Well, this is gay.
Why all the music?
Oh, we regulate our day by music. Yes. And now, my friends, I suggest you take advantage of our refreshing department.
Oh, leave me to it, mate. I'm starving.
Oh, you will eat later. Here, we revive the weary body.
Jamie puts a hand on Polly's arm.
Keep your eyes skinned.
Why? What's the matter?
Oh, they're a weird sort of folk. I don't know that I understand them.
In the refreshing department, vacuously smiling colonists are attended to by white-coated women. Barney flaps over to greet the visitors.
Pilot, control wish you to call them immediately. They wish to welcome our guests.
Oh, but of course. Switch on, please, my dear.
A wall screen lights up with the portrait of a handsome but stern-looking man.
Hey, who's that? He looks smashing.
That's our controller.
We wish to welcome joyfully the visitors to our colony. We are very grateful to them. They have performed a valuable service. The colony is to make our guests happy and contented during their stay. Welcome again, friends. Now, back to work, everyone.
Well, that's great. I'm really going to enjoy myself.
Splendid. And now, my good friends, let me put you into the hands of our supervisor, Barney. Dear old Barney, everybody calls him.
Oh, thank you, pilot.
And I must leave you for work calls, you know, and hard work never hurt anybody. Till later.
Delighted to see you. Delighted to have you with us. Now, you have a complete choice of all our treatments. We have steam baths, beauty treatments, perhaps a massage. You, sir, of course, would like your clothes cleaned. Then there's sunlight treatment, moonlight treatment, sparkling and effervescent sprays.
I feel perfectly all right as I am, thank you.
Go on, doctor. Don't be such a drag. It all looks super. Please, may I have a shampoo?
Shampoo, of course, for the young lady.
Thanks very much.
You.
And for the young gentleman, our very latest treatment in our cubicles over there.
Me? Oh, hey, no, you're not going to do that to me.
I'm no lassie.
Good shiny lassies have got you.
And believe me, mate, I'm not going to struggle.
And now, sir, for you.
The doctor's grin vanishes. A while later, Polly emerges with a new hairstyle.
Oh, very nice. Very nice indeed. You must certainly be the most beautiful young lady in our colony and are quite sure to be elected our next beauty president.
Thank you very much.
You're not at all. All part of our service.
Ben is sitting beneath a sun lamp, enjoying a massage.
At your liking, sir?
Ah, marvellous, like being an anchor in the med.
Some protective oils for our guests and a little suntan.
Ah, this is the life.
Hey, mister. Would you call the ladies off? I'm frightened what they might do to me.
Oh, but you look charming, sir, charming.
That's what I'm frightened of.
Barney moves over to where the doctor is encased in a small cubicle. His tousled head bobs briefly over the top.
Please get me out of here. I'm done for a turn.
Clothes reviver?
My first turn is reviving.
Oh, while we're about it, sir.
We hope you enjoyed this preview.
To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.